Seeking support as the guardian of her younger sibling, Yumi returns to a small hotel run by a family friend. As bizarre incidents creep up in her mother's old room, Yumi will have to unravel the supernatural mystery and discover the truth before it's too late. This film is entitled Lingering, and it's a very atmospheric and old-fashioned ghost story murder mystery. Great story and superb cast. It moves at a slow pace, but it's never boring. It has you guessing till the moment the killer is revealed. I highly recommend this. You know, this film, you know, it could have been one of those where I would just be like, I'm out of here, it's moving too slow. You know, hurry up already, you know. But I hung in there, and it's a big payoff at the end. The last, 20 minutes or so. And, it does throw you for a loop. There's a lot of things that they throw at you in this film. But it's not, you know, bad. It isn't. You know, I like the effort. It's something that you like to see. Well, at least me. I mean, I like being, you know, scared psychologically. Not so much gore or blood or guts or slashing and all that stuff. I don't mind that. I'll watch those. But you get an old-fashioned type of horror movie like this, and I don't know if this is even could be considered a horror movie. I would call it a like a ghost story, a murder mystery type of thing. But they have a lot of elements thrown into this film, and I can see what they're trying to go for, but at the same time, you know, I really I enjoyed it overall. You know, I think the actors in here were good. The main character, Yumi, and her younger sister, the actors are very good. Of course, in this movie, they are sisters who share same mother but different fathers. Their mother apparently committed suicide 5 years earlier. And when they go to the aunt's, well, it's a friend of theirs, but they consider her aunt. And they go there, and it all seems well, and all seems quaint and very, very just friendly. But then you see the aunt kind of showing shades of what she really is. You know, her maid, who's only there because of the pay, because everybody else left, according to her. This is a girl that's been telling Yumi stories about how this hotel turns you crazy. That's why a lot of people left. And then you see, over the course of the film, you hear the stories, and then you know that you realize that a number of people are being found dead, having hung themselves. And is it the hotel that's causing them to do it? Yeah, I mean, even her son, you know, the aunt's son, apparently went off to Australia to, to study or work, right? And then you find out the truth. This is older gentleman whose daughter, you know, believe he's talking about her disappearing. And you know, you find out that in turn all these people are actually dead. You know, the mother of the two girls found that young girl that the old man who's his daughter disappeared, and you know, find out that she's dead. And then the aunt figure killed their mom. Well, she admitted to it, but it took a lot of screaming on the part of the daughter. I mean, not the daughter, but the daughter of the mother. And this movie is like, you know, it just has just a lot of twists and turns. A lot of, the reveal was pretty good. You know, with regards to the aunt, that she was the one that killed people. She killed this police officer who was at first thinking that it was Yumi that was the one that was killing these people, because she would find a dead body, and then the cop is just like, you know, maybe she did it. You know, you could see that in his mind. He's telling her not to leave. And then he ends up getting killed by the aunt, the mother, you know, the aunt. And then she ties and drugs Yumi, and she's all bloody. I don't know if she was draining her blood. She would take some of that blood and put it on her son, who's been dead for like, I don't know how long. He's sitting there, his body's decaying, his mouth's open, agape, you know. And when she's trying to put the blood, Yumi's blood, on her son, her dead son, and then Yumi, you know, takes a glass, a bottle or something, and smashes it over her head. She goes to her sister to untie her, and then the struggle ensues between the aunt and Yumi, and then she's able to, you know, somehow, weird, it's like she's getting choked out by the aunt, and she passes out. I was thinking that she was pretending, because she was reaching for a glass, shattered glass under there. All of a sudden, you see, it looked like a hairpin or something that the younger sister had before. Apparently, she dropped it, and then it moved. It like moved on its own to Yumi, her hand, and she stabs the aunt in the side of the head, and she's able to get out of there. You see Yumi and her sister drive out and drive away, heading to her studio apartment. And that's where she says that's home. And then you see the aunt looking at her son. We all see what the son looks like. You know, he's decayed, he's dead. But she sees him as a living person. Come here, you know, he's telling him to come here. And then you see him reach out to her, and I thought that, you know, you're gonna see the decayed person become a zombie. I mean, that would have been another twist that would have been like kind of over the top. They kind of you know, kept the movie where it's just like, you know, they kept it within its capacity. They didn't try to throw anything else that would have made this thing unbearable to watch. Because that would have been crazy if they would have made him, you know, start eating her or start going for her throat. But you just basically see him reaching out to her. And, you know, we're kind of looking through her eyes, what she sees. Because he pretty much was saying that he's alive and all these other people are alive. You know, and it's like, no, you've been killing these people off and, you know, drugging them. She did with the mom. I don't know if she hung the mom or make it look like she killed herself, or she, but then she did say that she killed him, and in the end she did confess that to Yumi. So, but like I said, the movie was very, very good. Like I said, you know, it's moved, like I said, it moved at a slow pace, but like I said, it never got boring, and it kept you watching. Look at me watching. I'm like, I'm saying it kept you watching. It kept me watching, and I almost tapped out, but I said, okay, I'm gonna give it a chance or a shot, and then I did, and it turned out that it was actually a very good movie. I enjoyed it. Another one recommended by my one of my faithful subscribers. Thank you very much. And well, that's my recap and my thoughts of Lingering. It was a Shudder original. It was released this year in November, early November, and it's a South Korean film. Very good, as always, when it comes to either South Korea or Indonesia, Japan, you know, those movies, when they release a film like this, and even the action films and the horror films, they really do deliver. But well, that's my video, and for those of you who stopped by and checked it out, I appreciate it. And in closing, as always, take care.